Hello friends, I'm Urvashi. Welcome to my channel. So well, this video is in continuation of the last one where I'm talking about the impact of the retrograde motion of Mars on all the ascendants. So I've done the ascendants from Aries to Virgo in the last video, in the part one of this video. In this video, I'm going to be discussing the impact of this retrogression from Libra to Pisces. So just a reminder, if you haven't subscribed as yet, remember to subscribe. The subscription button is here. And well, if you've already subscribed, then great. It's great to have you back once again. We'll start off with Libra. So for Libra, Mars rules your second house of family and your seventh house of marriage, relationships, partnerships, and public image. And that is now exalted in the fourth house. So both these houses are for wealth. The second and the fourth house are both for wealth, for business, for partnerships, for profession. And it's exalted in the fourth house, retrograde conjunct Ketu. So again, there is going to be less of happiness for you to Libra. Don't worry about it, but it's going to be there. There's going to be a lot of, you know, heat inside of you, in the heart area, in the chest area. With this retrograde motion, be extra careful about your health. Be extra careful about coughs and fevers. There could be a bad cough that you develop. There could be you know, problems related to your chest and lungs. Do a lot of breathing exercises. Work out a lot. Go to the gym. Even better than gymming is yoga for you. Do a lot of yoga. Stay very busy. Use this energy to think. Use this energy to plan out for your profession, because Mars here is aspecting the 10th house. So whatever you have been planning for your profession, right now is the time to make a game plan, a complete game plan of what you are going to do once this planet goes direct. Now the impact directly is on the family. Family issues and issues related to your spouse, issues related to your happiness are in question right now. There's a lot of introspection that you're going to be doing at this time. There could be issues related to property. You could have a property that you've been wanting to sell. You could suddenly have news that it's selling and then it could be stalled again. So that also could be worrying you. But don't worry too much about it. It's all a temporary phase. Things are a little slow down, but nothing, you know, to worry about too much. Be careful of your speech, of your relationships. Try and stay happy as much as possible. Drink a lot of water. Do some yoga. That was for a Libra ascendant. For a Scorpio ascendant, Mars is the lord of the first house and the sixth house exalted in the third house. So well, that's the house of your efforts. That's the house of your courage. That's the house of your initiatives. And it's the lord of the sixth house, which is another house of growth, house of struggle. So here Mars is going to make you suddenly think about all the struggles that you've been doing, about all the efforts that you've been making, and about the futility of it all. You may suddenly feel that you're not getting the expected results out of it, because these are both houses of growth. Things are not growing in your favor. You may suddenly feel that, because it's also the first lord, you may suddenly feel that you do not want to make the effort, that you do not want to go out to office, that you do not want to go for your job. You may suddenly feel that you do not want to take any initiative. You may feel a lack of courage inside of you. You may be feeling very, very, very negative, especially if Scorpio is your moon sign, especially then. You may be feeling very negative inside. The third house also here, Mars Ketu exalted, Mars retrograde is also going to bring in a lot of anger inside of you. Mars here is aspecting your ninth house, the house of opportunity, and your 10th house. Be very careful of what you say. Your communication may end up at this point of time, you may end up losing an opportunity. You may end up making a mess of your job. Be very careful. Just zip up your mouth. For these 2 months, don't say much. Just keep your ears open. Remember to work out, to take some strength. For you, you need strenuous exercise, because there is a lot of energy in you. It's in the third house. That's a lot of energy. Go out, do some running every day, or you know, walk on the treadmill. Just do some strenuous exercise. Moon sign, then yes, then yoga will also help you. Do some yoga, do some meditation. Let this time pass. Don't worry so much about it. Some debts that you've taken, loans that you've taken, the effort that you put into your profession, a sudden health issue that you know has come up of late is going to be all bothering you right now. There's a lot of analysis that you're going to be doing. Better than that is that you do some meditation and give your mind some peace, because this time is going to pass. It's not a big deal. Once this goes, you know, once this time has passed, this is a great placement for you. This is a great placement to go out, put the right energy into your profession, and then achieve, and then grow. Because here, Mars in this third house, Lord of the sixth house, that's a great achievement. You will definitely get a position in your office. You will definitely achieve something in your profession, but now is the time to introspect, to internalize the energy. So that was for the sign of Scorpio. For the sign of Sagittarius, Mars is the ruler of the 12th house and the 5th house. It's exalted in the 2nd house. So what is going to be bothering you is your expenses. Your expenses are suddenly going to bother you quite a bit. Your expenses could be about your children. The expenses could be on studies for your children. The expenses could be about travel abroad. You could be planning to send your children abroad for studies, and that could be causing a big, you know, huge hole in your pocket that would be bothering you. The issue could be related to family at home. There could be a lot of unrest at home. There could be a, you know, loss in some business that could cause unrest at home. There could be expenditure on hospitals right now. A family member may have to go to the hospital. There could be huge expenditure on that particular hospital trip that could be bothering you a lot. There could be general unease, unhappiness in the family. Also, be careful about your speech, because here Mars, Ketu are in the second house, which is the house of speech. You could be a little rash in your own speech that could end up, you know, having a conflict in the family right now. So you too should be very careful about how you project yourself, how you talk, how you are within your family. Things may be a little tough for you right now, but it's important to be a little patient, to be soft. Again, you too can, for a Sagittarius ascendant, meditation I believe is very important for you, because it is going to impact you directly, your speech and your family. You need to be at peace a little bit. So spend some time by yourself and let this time pass. It's a good time to plan for your business for the future. It's a good time to plan for your children. Don't worry so much about the expenses. About the family front, things will pass. So don't worry too much about that too. For a Capricorn ascendant, Mars rules your 11th house and your 4th house. So the question in your mind is going to be about your own happiness, about your own friend circle, about your own associates, and whether and if they are bringing, you know, the happiness in your life or not. The question is going to be about a property that you've been wanting to, you know, get or buy, or a property you've been wanting to sell, and suddenly, you know, things are going to be stalled, and it's going to be a major issue in your mind. The issue can also be regarding health, because the 11th house Lord exalted in the first house with Ketu. Yes, the issue can also be health, depending of course on your dasha. So the question here can be about your health. But definitely the energy level in you is very high. The energy is going to be very, very introspective. You're going to be questioning your life at home. You're going to be questioning your own happiness. You're going to be questioning your friend circle, your networks, your associates, your long-term dreams and desires. You're going to be questioning where are you in life today vis-a-vis all that you wanted. You're going to be asking yourself whether all your choices were correct or not. You're going to be asking yourself whether you are happy today or not, whether you made the right choices. You're going to be asking yourself whether your friends are what you wanted them to be. You're going to be asking yourself about what your dreams were 15, 20 years back and how much of it you've achieved. So there's going to be this great introspective energy inside of you. It's great to introspect. It's great to analyze things. It's great to know where we are in life vis-a-vis what we planned. But do not bother yourself so much. Do not worry yourself sick thinking about this, because, you know, health could also give you trouble at this point of time. This is a lot of heat on the head area. Heat strokes can be expected at this point of time. Fevers can be expected at this point of time. So go slow, meditate a little bit, calm yourself down. Once Mars is direct, it's a great time to move on and, you know, achieve wherever. Put your energy in the right place. Put your energy in your profession. But for right now, just take it a little slow. So for an Aquarius ascendant, Mars is the Lord of the 10th house and the 3rd house. It's exalted in the 12th house. So the worry here for you right now, Aquarius, is going to be regarding, again, your profession, because Mars is the Lord of the 10th house and it's exalted in the 12th house. You may feel that all your effort has been wasted. You may feel there has been expenditure of all the effort, the third house's effort. You made a lot of effort in your profession and it has been wasted. It has gone waste. That is what your thought could be right now. You may feel there has been a lot of expenditure on travel, on enjoyment. The third house is your enjoyment also. And all that we do, you know, on an everyday basis, on a weekend we go out, we watch movies and we enjoy ourselves, we go to restaurants, that's the third house. So it's exalted in the 12th house. There could be a lot of expenditure related to all that. There could be a lot of expenditure on travel related to work. You may be traveling quite a bit and you may not at this point of time get the desired results. So if you're traveling for business, for profession, or even for your enjoyment, there could be obstacles and hurdles right now, which may consider, you know, make you think whether this was a good time to travel or not. So be careful. Do not make too many plans of travel from the end of June to the end of August. It's a good time to connect with your spiritual self. It's a good time to analyze your own subconscious self. So for a Pisces ascendant, Mars rules your 9th house and your 2nd house, and it's exalted in your 11th house. So for Pisces, this is one of the best positions. The Lord of the 9th and the Lord of the 2nd is exalted in the 11th house. It's a great yoga. But then it's retrograde. So the gains that you've been expecting, the growth that you've been expecting in your bank balance, you may suddenly feel that's not happening. You may suddenly feel that your friends could be acting like a hindrance in your growth. Your network circles could be, you may be partying and going out so much that you may not be putting in the right time in your own profession. You may feel an opportunity that was coming your way is suddenly slipping out of your hands because of your network circles. You may suddenly be working on your, phone book, trying to delete numbers that you don't want anymore. You may suddenly be wanting to clear out the old energy from your life. And it's a good time to actually be doing that, to clear out all the old energy that you don't need, to clear out all the extra baggage that sometimes we carry with ourselves, to, declutter our lives. So it's a good time to declutter our lives, to get rid of people that, have no positive contribution to your life. You may suddenly be feeling let down. In these 2 months, you may suddenly be feeling let down within your own network circles. So don't worry too much. Your philosophy you will be questioning right now. Your growth and gains in your profession you will be questioning right now. But this is all going to pass. It's a good time to analyze. It's a good time to declutter. Once Mars goes direct, this is a great position. It's all gains for you. So that is all for Pisces. I will be seeing you now in the next video. Remember to subscribe if you haven't as well. The subscription button is right here. Remember to subscribe and stay tuned. Bye-bye.